I work in the dairy sector. We are primarily working in solar, small lights and solar home lighting systems. Solar water heater, things like that. So one of our major challenges is end user financing. So solar is still costly for the rural population, and we try to kind of make solar affordable. And end user financing facilitation is one of the things that we do. And through linkages with banks and microfinance and other various financial institutes. So now in the sector that we work in, banking sector is not very developed, and most of the customers, they are not very comfortable dealing with the bank and they don't have accounts. So we replicated a model which was tried earlier by Selco and a few other organizations for end user financing, which is a revolving fund model. We also kind of changed it slightly to, so we didn't take it and put it as it is, but we kind of also innovated a bit on our model and did it. So under this model, what happens is we partner with an entrepreneur or an NGO, and then they kind of take a risk or assume the risk of repayment from the community. We provide the solar, and then they are our partner who collects the repayment and get it to us there. So we pay them a certain commission. Now this commission is again flexible depending on the entrepreneur and the partners. So we have also tried doing it ourselves for a few solar home systems, and we failed there. We're not really good at collecting money, so especially from relatives. Yeah. So I'll go to the challenge, and I'll also explain some of the details with the challenges. So the first challenge we have is finding the right partner. So this partner should ideally be from the local area, working in the local, somebody that people want to see, or somebody who has some kind of authority in that area that people trust him, and they also can find the right customers who won't be fall under this thing. So finding the right partner in that particular area that we want to work is a challenge that we have. And another thing is that arriving at the business model. So when we say business model, when we say revolving fund model, so we try different models with different partners and different entrepreneurs. Say, for example, different area may need different kind of products now. We cannot provide solar home systems the same model for everyone because the needs are different. So we design based on costing, product design. So again, based on those costings, like how much is something going to be, the duration of the revolving fund, the interest rate that they will pay, the commission for the entrepreneurs and the NGOs, like, and how do we pay the commission? Like some one partner NGO, they said, we will take the commission only when we completely pay back for the system. So after they fully recollect the money and they give us the last installment, they'll take the commission then. Now one entrepreneur, they said, I want it monthly for the collection, give us a percentage of the commission that I collect per month. What we have realized is this model, even though we can do the study and work out a model and start off, we have to tweak it in between as in when we go ahead. So sometimes we started off for a one, we thought that in one particular community, what they need basically is a solar home system or four light system. Now, after starting this model, after a few months, people can get said, can we also buy the solar water heater that you have under this model? Can we buy the 200 watt system, inverter system that you have under this model? Can we take a sewing machine under this model? So things like, so we have to again go back and think, oh, how do we do it then? How do we cost it differently? And now the biggest challenge for us, so this we started with some initial funding from ZIZ to Circle Foundation, another project where we have to replicate one of the innovations that they have done. So we have done two pilots with this, one with an NGO, one with an entrepreneur, and we also put in some of our money. Plus, from some other projects, we brought some money in this. Now, the pilots are successful in this, especially when we are working with an entrepreneur and an NGO. So, when we are talking about replicating this model, it can be either some other organization replicating this, or we replicating this with other partners, or scaling it up. Now, the challenge comes in here is the investment, initial investment that comes in. So, the investment required for this particular model that we work is, this is how we work. So, if we say we work with an NGO partner, we say that we will first invest some discourse of money, which can buy, say, 10 members of system, give it to 10 customers. Now, 10 customers repay their first installment, second installment. So, as and when this collection can pay for one more system, we finance one more system there. So, initial funding keeps getting revolved. So this is how the revolving fund works. So, the initial funding for this many number of systems is a challenge that we are facing. So, I think this is a very short about the project and the challenges that I have.
Thank you. We'll open it up to questions.
Yes, we can talk tomorrow. Just kidding.
How many times have you gone and knocked on the door of the bank and reminded them that they have an obligation to finance organizations like you, since you're actually working with a world bank that has a government regulation that is actually supposed to meet fund organizations like you?
Yeah, very, very times. Now, so the bank in this particular area, the banks, the branches that they have are tiny, and they cannot also finance as many customers as they want, and they'll give n number of reasons not to do it. And in some cases, the customers also don't want to deal with the bank. With all those paperwork, like 5 years of repayment, can we get it?
But you have, basically, you're providing supplier finance through your organization with the church group and the entrepreneur. Your organization should be able to borrow from the bank. I know it's very difficult.
Yes.
They have an obligation. Have you ever gone along with the church group that is working with you?
The bank is extending us credit. But that's for working capital. So now we have a choice: when we do we invest that money that we get into this, or do we finance our current working capital requirements? So we don't get specific funding for that particular money. So that we haven't tried. Asking, can you finance our entrepreneur or this NGO? That we haven't tried.
And have you tried to go together to say seek additional money for your organization, okay, for your working capital, okay, so you could have more, okay, and exercise so that you have a line of credit with it for, let's say it's $2 lakh, okay, and once you've done that for 6 months, go in again, can we raise our working capital up to $3 lakh and then to $4 lakh, so you incrementally get...
Together we haven't gone for the purpose, but we went together and then discuss on how their board can finance this set of customers, right? So those people whom the bank cannot finance, they can probably refer to this NGO. And the NGO, if somebody wants a very low installment, then they can then refer to the bank for somebody. So for that happen, yeah. Yes. Okay, so we are with the NGO, we're living in Jochangpur now, with the entrepreneur in one of the villages. So we started out with the NGO just with 10 systems. And now we have financed more than 50 systems. So what happened is, in the past few months, so the bank has not been financing very well. And so we had more customers coming in for the revolving fund. But we didn't have money in that corpus fund, so we have also put in some more money from our side. And the number is increased over 40, 50 in between. So this is mostly in Chosankuri. Yes, yes, it's very much true. And Hill districts, again, like most people know, they don't have that access to banks now. And the NGO we are working with is a church-based NGO. So they spread the word through the churches, and the customers also come to the churches. So that way, I think the default and repayment happens lesser, because they're not really religious, they come through the religion route there. So that's how it is.